I'm going to cover how to enter data and get a regression line summary using a Casio 9750 graphing calculator. And I'm going to do this in three stages. First, enter the data, then look at a graph of the data, and finally fit a regression line. I'm going to start by going to the Stats section by hitting Menu and then going over to Stat. Next, I'll want to enter the data into two lists. Here, I'm going to use List 1 and List 2, but you can use any two lists you want. I'll need to first delete the data that's in the list, which I can do one observation at a time, or if I arrow over with F6 and choose the Delete All option, I can delete all the observations a little bit faster. With that, I'm ready to enter my sample dataset, which has 10 observations. Before I calculate the regression line, it's also a good idea to look at a plot. I can do this by navigating to Graph, then set the graph parameters. Here I'm going to use graph 1, which is shown as a scatter plot using lists 1 and 2. If I needed to change a list number, I'd go to List, hit F1, and then enter the proper list number. I find it easier to always enter my data into list 1 and list 2, and that way I don't need to update this each time. But if you do occasionally use other lists, verify the proper lists are always set for whatever calculations or graphing you're going to do. Now I can exit out and show graph 1. A downward trend is evident in the data, so I should expect a negative slope when fitting the line. The trend also looks reasonably linear, and there are no outliers that are a cause for concern. Alright, now that I've checked that the data look reasonable for fitting a regression line, I'll exit out, go to Calc, then to Set, and I'll specify the regression context. I need to make sure the proper lists are set, just like I did when I was graphing. Exiting back to the previous screen, I'm finally ready to compute the regression line. To do so, I choose Reg for regression line, then X for linear regression line, and then I prefer the form A plus BX, so I'll choose that option. The regression output shows the form of the equation, the y-intercept of the best fit line, the slope of the best fit line, the correlation, the r-squared value, and the mean squared error of the residuals. The final equation of the line is y equals 93.71 minus 1.94 times x. Notice the negative slope, which made sense with the scatter plot I examined earlier. Here's a plot of the data with the regression line shown. In the next video, I'll cover how to perform a t-test to evaluate whether there is strong evidence that the slope of the line is different than zero. If you liked this video, give it a thumbs up below and subscribe. Thanks for watching.